Hello kids, let's start with our English subject, chapter 21, The Journey to the Great Oz. Let's begin. The Wizard of Oz is a well-known fantasy of children's literature. Fantasy means imaginative fiction involving magic and adventure. If it tells the story of Dorothy, who is whisked with her dog Toto by the cyclone to the wonderful land of Oz. Whisk means over here, take or move somewhere suddenly and quickly. Cyclone, a tropical storm. There she meets the Tin Woodman, who needs a heart, the Scarecrow, who needs brain, and Cowardly Lion, who needs bravery. They all want to see the Wizard of Oz, the only person who can help them. Here's an account of a part of their journey to the Emerald City of Oz, where the Wizard lives. Emerald means bright green. Read the Wizard of Oz to find out what happens next. The Wizard of Oz was written by Lyman Frank Baum, 1856 and 1919. He has written many other books about Oz. This classic novel was also made into a movie. This was to be an eventful day for the travelers. Eventful means marked by interesting or exciting events. They had hardly been walking an hour when they saw before them a great ditch that crossed the road and divided the forest as far as they could see on either side. Ditch means a deep opening or gap in the ground. It was a very wide ditch, and when they crept up to the edge and looked into it, they could see it was also very deep, and there were many big jagged rocks at the bottom. Crept means move slowly and carefully in order to avoid being heard or noticed. Jagged means with rough, sharp points poking out. The sides were so steep that none of them could climb down, and for a moment it seemed that their journey must end. "What shall we do?" asked Dorothy despairingly. Despairingly means hopelessly, miserably. "I haven't the faintest idea," said the Tin Woodman, and the Lion shook his shaggy mane and looked thoughtful. Faintest means weakest. Shaggy means long, thick, and untidy. But the Scarecrow said, "We cannot fly, that is certain. Neither can we climb down into this great ditch. Therefore, if we cannot jump over it, we must stop where we are." "I think I could jump over it," said the Cowardly Lion, after measuring the distance carefully in his mind. "Then we are all right," answered the Scarecrow, "for you can carry us all over on your back, one at a time." "Well, I'll try it," said the Lion. "Who will go first?" "I will," declared the Scarecrow. "For if you found that you could not jump over the gulf, Dorothy would be killed or the Tin Woodman badly dented on the rocks below." Dent means a slight hollow in a hard, even surface. "But if I am on your back, it will not matter so much, for the fall would not hurt me at all." "I am terribly afraid of falling myself," said the Cowardly Lion. "But I suppose there is nothing to do but try it. So get on my back and we will make the attempt." The Scarecrow sat upon the lion's back, and the big beast walked to the edge of the gulf and crouched down. Gulf means a very deep opening or gap in the ground. Crouch means a position where the knees are bent and the upper body is brought forward and down in preparation for jumping. "Why don't you run and jump?" asked the Scarecrow. "Because that isn't the way we lions do these things," he replied. Then, giving a great spring, he shot through the air and landed safely on the other side. They were all greatly pleased to see how easily he did it. And after the scarecrow had got down from his back, the lion sprang across the ditch again. Dorothy thought she would go next. So she took Toto in her arms and climbed on the lion's back, holding tightly to his mane with one hand. The next moment it seemed as if she were flying through the air. And then, before she had time to think about it, she was safe on the other side. The lion went back a third time and got the Tin Woodman. And then they all sat down for a few moments to give the beast a chance to rest. For his great leaps had made his breath short and he panted like a big dog, then has been running too long. Pant means breath with short, quick breath, typically from exertion or excitement. They found the forest very thick on this side and it looked dark and gloomy. Gloomy means poorly lit, depressing. After the lion had rested, they started along the road of yellow bricks, silently wandering, each in his own mind. If ever they would come to the end of the woods and reach the brightest sunshine again. To add to their discomfort, they soon heard strange noises in the depth of the forest. And the lion whispered to them that it was in this part of the country that the Kalidas lived. "What are the Kalidas?" asked the girl. "These are monstrous beasts with bodies like bears and heads like tigers," replied the lion, "and with claws so long and sharp that they could tear me in two as easily as I could kill Toto. I'm terribly afraid of the Kalidas." "I'm not surprised that you are," returned Dorothy. "They must be dreadful beasts." "Dreadful? Terrible." The lion was about to reply when suddenly they came to another gulf across the road. But this one was so broad and deep that the lion knew at once he could not leap across it. So they sat down to consider what they should do. And after serious thought, the scarecrow said, "Here is a great tree standing close to the ditch. If the Tin Woodman can chop it down so that it will fall to the other side, we can walk across it easily." "This is a first-rate idea," said the lion. "One would almost suspect you had brains in your head instead of straw." First-rate means the best, excellent. The woodman set to work at once, and so sharp was his axe that the tree was soon chopped nearly through. Then the lion put his strong front legs against the tree and pushed with all his might. And slowly the big tree tipped and fell with a crash across the ditch with its top branches on the other side. They had just started to cross the square bridge when a sharp growl made them all look up. Growl means roar. And to their horror, they saw running towards them two great beasts with bodies like bears and heads like tigers. "They are the Kalidas," said the cowardly lion, beginning to tremble. "Quick," cried the scarecrow, "let's cross over." So Dorothy went first, holding Toto in her arms. The Tin Woodman followed, and the scarecrow came next. The lion, although he was certainly afraid, turned to face the Kalidas, and then he gave so loud and terrible a roar that Dorothy screamed. And the scarecrow fell over backward, while even the fierce beast stopped short and looked at him in surprise. But seeing they were bigger than the lion, and remembering that they were two of them and only one was there, the Kalidas again rushed forward and the lion crossed over the tree and turned to see what they would do next. Without stopping an instant, the fierce beast also began to cross the tree. And the lion said to Dorothy, "We are lost, for they will surely tear us to pieces with their sharp claws. But stand close behind me, and I will fight them as long as I am alive." "Wait a minute," called the scarecrow. He had been thinking what was best to be done, and now he asked the woodman to chop away the end of the tree that rested on their side of the ditch. The tin woodman began to use his axe at once, and just as the two Kalidas were nearly across, the tree fell with a crash into the gulf, carrying the ugly, snarling brutes with it, and both were dashed to pieces on the sharp rocks at the bottom. Snarl means make an aggressive growl with bare teeth. Brute means beast, wild animals. "Well," said the cowardly lion, drawing a long breath of relief, "I see we are going to live a little while longer. And I am glad of it, for it must be a very uncomfortable thing not to be alive. Those creatures frighten me so badly that my heart is beating yet." "Ah," said the tin woodman sadly, "I wish I had a heart to beat." This adventure made the travelers more anxious than ever to get out of the forest, and they walked so fast that Dorothy became tired and had to ride on the lion's back. To their great joy, the trees became thinner the further they advanced, and in the afternoon, they suddenly came upon a broad river flowing swiftly just before them. On the other side of the water, they could see the road of yellow brick running through a beautiful country with green meadows dotted with bright flowers, and all the road bordered with trees hanging full of delicious fruits. Meadows means grassland. They were greatly pleased to see this delightful country before them.